Sega Drunk.
As many of you know, I grew up with the Super Nintendo and subsequently missed out on a ton of Sega Genesis games, so I'm trying to make videos like this a bigger part of the channel. I have never heard of Forgotten Worlds until someone mentioned it on a comment a few weeks ago. Never seen it, never heard anyone talk about it, so I'm going into this game with zero knowledge. It's a 1989 arcade port from Capcom, notable for being the first game from them made for their CPS arcade boards that eventually produced all the great Capcom arcade classics like Street Fighter II, Final Fight, Ghouls and Ghosts, and Strider, just to name a few. But yeah, this was the first, so you might think Forgotten Worlds would play a little clunky or look and sound a little sloppy, but this is a quality title, especially for an arcade port in the late 80s. As you can see, this is a side-scrolling run-and-gun title that runs just as fast and as smoothly as you'd expect from a Genesis title, which reminds me, I neglected to mention in the Ghouls and Ghosts video I did a while back, Capcom really knew what they were doing when it came to arcade ports, because Forgotten Worlds is another game with zero slowdown. That's something you couldn't say about many early Super Nintendo titles. Anyway, the controls here are a bit different than you might expect. You use the A and C buttons to rotate around as the B button fires. You'll notice you also have kind of a pod that floats around you, sort of like an R-type, that acts as a backup firepower sort of thing. So yeah, you make your way to the right, you make stuff go boom, and you collect these blue things that function as currency, and you use that to buy stuff at these shops that pop up out of nowhere in the middle of the level. That's pretty cool. You can buy weapon upgrades like homing missiles, or extra energy, or armor, and even hints on how to beat the boss. As you might expect, this game is pretty dang hard, but you at least have a life bar instead of one-hit deaths. The level design is about what you'd expect. Each level starts out pretty wide open and eventually narrows down to tighter spacers, like where these flames try and kill you here. And of course, boss fights are a highlight, with them usually taking up the entire screen. But of course, the big reason you'd want to play Forgotten Worlds today is that it's two-player co-op. This game is even structured in a way that encourages a second player, because if you play by yourself, if you die, it's game over. Start at the beginning of the level. If you're playing with another player, if you die, you can always continue right where you are as long as the other player is still alive. That makes it really easy to progress and see the entire game. The only real problem with that is Forgotten Worlds is pretty dang short if you play a two-player. You could probably finish it in around 30 minutes. But yeah, Forgotten Worlds is a game that was completely off my radar, never heard of it until now, but I'm glad I did. It's a quality arcade port that's especially fun with a second player. Yeah, it's not a long game, but you can at least play through it again and try out some different weapons. The cartridge can usually be had for around $10 to $12. And this game also came out for Amiga, Sega Master System, TurboGrafx-16, and a few other systems, but I can only speak for the Genesis version, which is also available on the Wii Virtual Console. It's a quality title that's a fun way to spend a half an hour or so.